are areas of the city that are more prone to flooding, and there are corners that will flood first and drain last. And it's those are the hot spots that the city needed to know about in terms of figuring out where we should be putting our green infrastructure projects, where we need to be focusing our attention for engineered solutions to our flood risk.
New Orleans is a place that is defying, I want to say its natural state. New Orleans is supposed to be, in all intents and purposes, a swamp.
Everyone here has a story about flooding, if not multiple stories. You know, if you've lived in New Orleans for more than 6 months, you've got stories to tell.
So when it comes to climate change, it's often just communicated with data. And so I had a back of a napkin idea about reversing the entire process of working with communities and having them say, you know, I've noticed this. I've noticed this changing in my daily life. I said, why don't we start, you know, by giving people these rain gauges and having them document their blocks and understand their flood risk and saying, this is what's changing in my backyard. And how does that relate to the bigger picture changes in the data? And that very idea of flipping the script on how climate change had been traditionally communicated was kind of the birth of IC Change. And so IC Change is about answering questions I care about in my daily life around climate change. And we want to make it for communities to tell us whatever they think about what's changing in their environment and in their community that's important to them. It's its own kind of social media that we invented to talk about climate change and weather. So you create a profile, it's on your phone, it's on your computer. We have IC Changers in 118 countries talking about climate change.
I am one of the community managers for IC Change New Orleans. I have been able to just see people's excitement to want to get involved. Rather, that's like just hosting a rain gauge or wanting to just like take pictures and document what they're seeing.
Really, that qualitative data from community members is really essential. I don't understand what's going on from just a photo alone. There's got to be that annotation, that context, what this means to someone from this community.
I kind of got more involved with IC Change just on like a volunteer observation basis. Literally anytime I was like driving or walking or biking, anywhere I saw a puddle, I would take a picture and post about it. The more stories we get about a specific spot or a specific issue, the more people are like, oh, that is a problem. The thing is that if it affects these residents, it affects me as well, because I do live here. You know, our founder lives here. So if the residents are experiencing it, we are as well.
You know, you may even be able to see a picture of flooding from one of the new generations of satellites, but what does that flooding mean to this person? What does it mean to my daily life? Is this something that I'm just willing to live with, or is this the deal breaker for me to leave my community? And indeed, 2017 was one of the record-breaking years for rainfall in New Orleans. We had record-breaking warm water in the Gulf, and between Maria and Harvey, we flooded during an average afternoon rainstorm. Really took out people's cars, really shook the city up, really scared people. I don't think we had experienced anything like that since Katrina. I am well aware of what the models are saying, where I live, and what the risks are, and yet the joy that I derive from being able to look out at the bayou every day is a risk that I've decided that I'm willing to take.
I was born and raised here. New Orleans is a very cultural place. I think that's one thing that I want to say New Orleanians pride themselves on.
It's worth it to, you know, say, this is a place, this is my home. Also, you know, feeling like this is my home makes me want to do more to fix it.
When it comes to adapting to climate change, it is not data or logic that's going to move the needle. It is love. You know, I love this community and I love my home, and I'm going to fight for it because of that love. You know, I have a kid and he's 3.5. He inherits the world that I've given him. And so that means that I'm going to do everything in my power to make that the best I possibly can. Because climate change asks of us something that has never been asked of humanity ever, which is for us to connect to each other in a local and a global way, to see beyond our boundaries, to understand our relationships with each other, and it could really, truly make us better people.